had done meter who will tell me what is the principle of meter bridge? Yes. Who will tell me what is the principle of a meter bridge? Yes, students. What is the principle of a meter bridge? Anyone? Mansi, what is the principle of a meter bridge? Mansi, we discussed light wire bridge or meter bridge yesterday. I'm asking what is its principle?
It is based on the principle of Wheatstone bridge.
Yes, it is practical form of Wheatstone
bridge,
based on Wheatstone bridge principle only. It is based on Wheatstone bridge principle only. What is Wheatstone bridge principle? Who will tell me? We also derived its condition of sensitivity yesterday. What is the principle of the Wheatstone bridge? Yes, who will tell? What is Wheatstone bridge principle? Yes, Yashika, batao. What is the principle of Wheatstone bridge? Yashika? Yes, Yashika. What's Wheatstone bridge principle? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah?
Null deflection.
हाँ हरसिमर क्या कह रहे हो आप?
Null deflection.
Action. When no current flows through the galvanometer, then P over Q is equal to R over S. The ratio of resistances in two arms of potentiometer that remains equal when no current flows through galvanometer. This is the principle of Wheatstone bridge, right? And this is the principle, same principle on which meter bridge is based. Okay, so we did that yesterday. And what was the formula of unknown resistance? This is the main application of meter bridge. So we derived a formula also for S. Who will tell me that formula? S is how much? Yes, students, hurry up, come on. Study all these topics side by side. Yes, Mayank. What is the formula for unknown resistance? Mayank. Yes, Mayank. No idea? Hitesh? Hitesh?
Yes, ma'am. As ma'am, our unknown resistance thing, it is equal to R into 100 minus L upon L.
Yes, very good. S is 100 minus L over N into capital R. That was known resistance here. Okay, so our next topic is potentiometer. Write down potentiometer. It is a device used to measure EMF. It's a device used to measure EMF of a cell. Already we have defined EMF. Kaun batayega EMF kya hoti hai? What do you understand by EMF? Yes, students, what do you understand? Yeah.
Potential difference across the terminals of cell when no current is drawn from it.
Yes, very good. So it is the potential difference between the terminals of a cell in an open circuit. That is when E is not pressed, when no current is being drawn from the cell. So a potentiometer gives us EMF of a cell. Now the question is, voltmeter is also a device used to find the potential difference. Then why do we need a potentiometer to find the potential difference, or we can say EMF of a cell? Why it is required? Because the reason is potentiometer is based on null method. Like a meter bridge is also based on null method. Potentiometer is also based on null method. We note down the reading when no current is being drawn from the cell, when galvanometer is showing zero, a deflection, right? So it gives us exact value of EMF of E. Okay? So if it's more now, it gives exact EMF of a cell, exact value of EMF of a cell. Whereas in case of a voltmeter, there is no such case, there is no such thing like null method. So it gives us reading when current is being drawn from the cell. So always there is some voltage drop taking place, because of which we are not getting exact value of EMF of the cell. We are only getting approximate value of EMF of the cell. So that's why this is the answer to the same question, that why is a potentiometer preferred to a voltmeter? Write down this conceptual question. Why is a potentiometer preferred over a voltmeter? So there you can explain this point, that potentiometer gives us exact value of EMF of a cell as it is based on null method. It gives us reading when no current is being drawn from the cell. Whereas in case of voltmeter, there is always some voltage drop taking place across the resistance, because of which we get only approximate value of EMF of the cell. We don't get exact value of EMF of the cell. Is that clear? Okay, so potentiometer, let us discover its principle now. How does it look like? Suppose this is point A, this is point B. Then there is 4 meter long wire. Here, there is 4 meter long wire with markings 0 to 100, 101 to 200, 201 to 300 centimeter, and then 301 to 400 centimeter. Okay, this is how this device looks like. So potentiometer, it is consisting of a 4 meter long wire, whereas in case of meter bridge, we had only 1 meter long wire. So here we have 4 meter long wire. Then this is the sense EMF we want to find, and here we connect the positive of battery emitter, one way T, a rheostat, so this is the circuit of it. And this side we have a galvanometer, and this galvanometer absorbs the current to find the balancing length. So in this case also we use jockey, but it is not called slide wire bridge. Though we are using jockey, it is not called slide wire bridge. What is the reason? That will be just clear to you. What is the reason behind that? Though we are using jockey, we don't call it slide wire bridge. So let's find out. What is the principle? R is equal to rho L by A. And V is equal to IR. Put this R here. V is equal to I rho L by A. Now, if these three factors are constant, if I, rho, and area of cross section are constants, then V is directly proportional to L. This is the principle of a potentiometer. That potential difference across any portion of potentiometer wire is directly proportional to length of that portion of wire, provided constant current flows through uniform wire. रो तो मटेरियल के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है, वो तो पहले से ही लगा हुआ है, जो भी मटेरियल है दैट इज अकॉर्डिंगली चोजन. सो द कंडीशंस आर कांस्टेंट करंट मस्ट पास थ्रू यूनिफॉर्म वायर, द वायर ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. देन द पोटेंशियल ड्रॉप अक्रॉस एनी पोर्शन ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर वायर दैट विल बी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू लेंथ ऑफ दैट पोर्शन ऑफ वायर. दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर. सो राइट इट इन वर्ड्स ऑल्सो. राइट नाउ you must know the principle of each and every device. So write it down, principle of a potentiometer. Principle of a potentiometer. write down the potential difference across any portion of potentiometer wire, the potential difference across any portion of potentiometer wire is directly proportional to the length of that portion of wire provided constant current flows through uniform wire So here comes the reason why we don't slide jockey over potentiometer wire, because it is based on the principle that wire should have uniform area of cross section. If we will slide jockey over the wire, uniformity of the wire may be spoiled. It may not be uniform anymore. So that's why to retain the uniformity of the wire, jockey is not slided. We just press against different points and check slightly. We just press it slightly against different points and then we check for the null point, for the balance point. Okay, so remember, this is a good Viva question as well. Why potentiometer is not called slide wire bridge, though we are using jockey here also? So what is answer to that? Because potentiometer is based on this principle, based on this condition that uniformity of the wire should be retained. So to retain the uniformity of wire, jockey is not slided over the wire, right? So I hope the principle is clear to you. Then there are, how can we check whether our connections are right or whether this potentiometer is giving exact value or right value of EMF of the cell? What we will do, we will connect all these things. We will press the key and then we will keep the jockey here at A point and at B point. Deflection should be opposite. When we keep the jockey at A point and at B point, deflection should be in the opposite direction. If the potentiometer is giving deflection in the same direction, that means there could be two reasons. Likhiye wo reasons kya ho sakte hain? This is very common conceptual question. What are the reasons of a potentiometer giving one-sided deflection sometimes? So balance point tab tak nahi aayega jab tak A aur B point pe deflection opposite sides pe nahi hogi. Meter bridge mein bhi aise hi hum perform karte hain. Balancing point galvanometer pe zero tabhi aayega when A and B points will have deflections in the opposite direction. So first of all, we have to manage accordingly, right? So write down the reasons. What are two reasons because of which this can happen? One-sided deflection may be there in potentiometer. So first reason is that connections may be of wrong polarity. Aise ho sakta hai ki humne connections wrong polarity ke lagaye hue hain. But what is the main reason? Write the second reason. This is supply EMF jo hum supply de rahe hain battery eliminator ko use karke. And this is unknown EMF that we want to find. So the thing may be that supply EMF may be less than unknown EMF. Ho sakta hai ki hum yahan pe 1 volt de rahe hain aur jo unknown cell hai uski EMF 1.5 volt hai. To us case mein hamara ye fault aa jayega. Theek hai? So this unknown EMF jo hai wo usse kam honi chahiye. Driver cell se kam honi chahiye. ठीक है, तो लिख लीजिए ये क्वेश्चन रीजन. सो सेकंड रीजन इज इफ द सप्लाई ईएमएफ इज लेस देन द ईएमएफ ऑफ अननोन सेल. इफ सप्लाई ईएमएफ इज लेस देन द अननोन ईएमएफ, तब भी ऐसे हो सकता है. एंड इनफैक्ट दिस इज द मेन रीजन. यही मेन रीजन है हमारा, राइट? ओके, नाउ देयर आर टू एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ अ पोटेंशियोमीटर. टू एप्लीकेशंस First application is to compare EMFs of two cells. We can use potentiometer to compare EMFs of two cells. This is first application. And later we will be doing the second application also. Let us do the first one. So suppose in the circuit now two cells are connected. In place of one, we are having two cells. So this is EMF E1, this is EMF E2, and this is a two-way key here. This is a two-way key having three terminals, terminal 1, 2, and 3. So second terminal, okay, this second terminal, you can say, you draw the circuit here, banaiye circuit diagram side by side, complete this first. Then central terminal say we connect the galvanometer and then we connect the job. So this is the circuit diagram and it's very important again for the reason it is covered in theory as well as in practical also you have to draw this circuit diagram on your own. So draw the circuit diagram first and you need not ask when we are asked to compare EMFs of two cells. Whether we have to draw the circuit or not, without circuit diagram, no meaning. So if you have drawn the circuit, let us come to the method now. So what is done in this case? See that, first of all, the key is placed here. Yahan pe key place kar dete hain. Theek hai? This circuit becomes complete. And cell E1 comes into the circuit. Cell E1 aa jayega. Then we will check jockey for the move jockey over the wire to all the portions to find the null point, to find the balancing length. Where we get zero on the galvanometer, jahan pe galvanometer, we will have our eyes on galvanometer pointer. So hum jockey ko check kar rahe hain, jahan pe galvanometer mein zero aa gaya, we will stop there and find the length. Suppose yahi pe aaya balancing length. So how much is L? This was 100. 101 se leke, suppose this was 55. Ya 60 le lo, 60. So your balancing length is this plus this, 160 centimeter. Okay. For example, your balancing length in this case is 160 centimeter. अब अगर आपका पॉइंट यहां कहीं आया होता तो कितनी होती बैलेंसिंग लेंथ? Who will tell me? अगर आपका बैलेंस पॉइंट वहां होता तो कितनी बैलेंसिंग लेंथ होती? Who will tell me? Yes, students? कितनी होती लेंथ? It's very easy to assume. Suppose ये पोर्शन 10 है, 10 सेंटीमीटर है, बताइए. Who will tell me? Yes. Kitni? Yes, Shivam.
Ma'am, 610 ho jayegi.
600.
Haan, ma'am, 10 bhi plus karna na uske andar, pehle 600 to nahi.
600 kahan se aaya bachche? Length of the wire is 4 meter, 400 centimeter maximum.
Achha, achha,
400 to total hai na. Ye dekhiye scale. 0 se leke 100, 101 se 200, 201 se 300, 301 se 400. Ye. To agar yahan pe aaya hai to ye kitna hua? 310 suppose. So here the balancing length is suppose 310 centimeter. Is that clear to everyone now? Is it clear, student? Haan ji, Vidisha bolo.
मैम ये सेकंड वाला दोबारा बताना जो आपने बताया एक बार
310 कैसे आया
यस मैम
ये देखो ना यहां तक लेंथ कितनी है 300 है आपका बैलेंसिंग पॉइंट यहाँ पे आ रहा है, तो ये 10 सेंटीमीटर और काउंट करोगे, तो जितनी आप नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट वायर पे जाते जा रहे हो ऐड करते जाओगे लेंथ, तो इसका मतलब आपका बैलेंस पॉइंट 310 सेंटीमीटर. गॉट इट विदिशा?
यस मैम.
ओके ओके. So suppose to do the article, let us assume that the balancing length is L1, right? Let us assume that the balancing length is L1. So according to the principle of potentiometer, E1 is directly proportional to L1. According to principle of potentiometer, E1 is directly proportional to L1. All right? And now we remove the key from here and put the key here. Now this cell will come into the circuit. Accordingly, we will check for the balance point and find the balancing length L2 corresponding to this cell E2. So according to principle of potentiometer, now E2 is directly proportional to L2. You remember na, principle of potentiometer is V proportional to L. So in the first case, our potential difference was E1 and length was L1. In the second case, it was E2 and L2. So accordingly, we have written. So dividing now, we get E1 over E2 is L1 over L2. So this will give us a comparison of EMFs of two cells. Already we have measured the balancing lengths L1 and L2. Our reading already hai hamare paas. So we will just substitute it here and we will get the ratio of two EMFs of the cell. So I hope the method is clear to you. You have to explain this for this application. And this is your experimental activity as well. Okay. Now the question is, kaun se do cells le rahe hum yahan pe to compare their EMFs? This is certainly battery eliminator. Yahan pe to humne battery eliminator lagayi hai. Kaun se do cells hain? आपके माइंड में क्वेश्चन आया होगा. सो नोट डाउन, वी टेक फॉर प्रैक्टिकल पर्पसेस डेनियल सेल, दैट वी विल प्रिपेयर देन एंड देयर, फ्रेशली प्रिपेयर डेनियल सेल एंड लेक्लेंचे सेल. वी टेक दीज टू सेल्स, डेनियल सेल एंड लेक्लेंचे सेल आर यूज. यू नो व्हाट इज एक्चुअल ईएमएफ ऑफ डेनियल सेल? 1.1 समथिंग volt, and Leclanché cell, this is the previous form of dry cell, so its EMF is 1.5 volt. So aapko pehle hi idea hoga ki hamari ratio kitni aane wali hai, to wo aap answer verify kar sakte, right? So this is our first application to compare EMFs of two cells. Is that right? Have a look at the whole article. If any doubt is there, you can ask. Yes, students, you can ask if any doubts you are having. Yes.
Memo uniformity wala point repeat kar do.
Haan ji.
Samay nahi aaya tha.
Kya?
Uniformity wala point.
Which point? जो एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन हमने कॉन्स्टेंट अज्यूम किया है तभी वी प्रोपोर्शनल टू एल, अदरवाइज नहीं है. इसका मतलब हमारा ये प्रिंसिपल जो हम यूज कर रहे हैं, इट इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली वेन द वायर विल हैव यूनिफॉर्म एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. इफ वी विल स्लाइड जॉकी हार्ड ऑन द वायर, देन वायर विल नो मोर रिमेन यूनिफॉर्म. मीटर ब्रिज में ऐसी कोई कंडीशन नहीं थी, तो इसलिए वी डिडंट बॉदर. वहां पे हम जॉकी को स्लाइड कर देते हैं, पर यहाँ पे हम जॉकी को वायर के ऊपर स्लाइड नहीं करते, क्योंकि वायर की यूनिफॉर्मिटी डैमेज हो सकती है, एंड वी विल नो मोर बी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एल. सो आर प्रिंसिपल विल वॉन्ट बी एप्लीकेबल देन. सो दैट्स वाई वी डोंट स्लाइड द जॉकी ओवर पोटेंशियोमीटर वायर. हम उसको स्लाइटली डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स पे टच करते हैं और फिर देखते हैं गैल्वेनोमीटर में जीरो कहां पे है. ठीक है, इज दैट क्लियर गीतेश?
यस मैम.
ओके, सेकंड एप्लीकेशन नाउ. सेकंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर इज टू फाइंड इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ अ सेल, टू फाइंड द इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ अ सेल. To find the internal resistance of a cell. You know what is the formula of internal resistance? Kaun batayega mujhe before vacation in the extra classes we did that? Yes, very good. Kaun batayega? Formula for internal resistance. Relation between internal resistance, EMF and terminal potential difference. All in one. One formula we had derived. Yes. Hurry up.
Mama, R equals to E minus V upon V into capital R.
Yes, very good. So the formula for internal resistance was E over V minus 1 into external resistance R. So this formula we will be using. So yahan pe external resistance to chala hume pata chal jayega. How to find E by V? We will do using potentiometer. So see the circuit diagram first. Idhar to same hi rahega. Here we will make some changes. Now there is only one cell. Here we have that external resistance, this resistance box, and one more key K1. This is key K, this is K1. So draw the circuit diagram. This is key K1. Yes, draw the circuit diagram first. Okay, done. So what is the method? First of all, we will keep the key K1 open. We won't be closing this key first. Isko open rehne denge. Theek hai? So now your cell will be in an open circuit. The potential difference across its terminals will be E. No current will be drawn from it, right? So we will locate balancing length. When galvanometer will show zero, we will note down the length in the same way, right? So according to the principle of principle of potentiometer, E is directly proportional to L1. Suppose that balancing length is L1. So we have kept key K1 open. So cell is in open circuit and potential difference across its terminals is E, not V. So that's why we write E in place of V. So E is proportional to L1. This is our first step. So we'll take one reading by keeping the key K1 open. Now we will close this key K1. Now the current will start flowing through the cell. Ab cell jo hai wo closed circuit mein aa jayega. Now the potential difference across its terminals will be V, not E. Because cell is working now. Now again using Jockey, we find the balancing length. Suppose that balancing length is L2, right? So we write V is proportional to L2. Got this thing? Ki wahan maine E kyun likha hai, yahan V kyun likha hai? Simply, open circuit mein potential difference EMF hota hai. Closed circuit mein potential difference, terminal potential difference hota hai. To pehle jo length aayi wo L1 thi, ab jo length aayi wo L2 thi. Any doubt in this? Any doubt in methodology? Yes. Yes, students, any doubt here? Okay. So then we have to just divide two equations. Divide these two equations. So we get E over V is L1 over L2. Put it in equation number one. आर तो हमने यहां से चूज करके ही रीडिंग लेनी है, ठीक है? आर की कोई वैल्यू तो निकालेंगे जब हम की के वन को क्लोज करेंगे. तो इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस वैल्यू वी आर हैविंग वी विल टेक 2-3 रीडिंग्स एंड एवरेज ले लेंगे. सो पुट इन इक्वेशन नंबर 1 वी गेट द फॉर्मूला फॉर इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस. सो पुटिंग इन द वैल्यूज वी विल फाइंड इट्स इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस. सो दिस विल गिव अस इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ दिस अननोन सेल दैट वी आर यूजिंग. सो हियर प्रैक्टिकली व्हिच सेल वी यूज ईदर लेक्लेंचे सेल और डेनियल सेल दैट इज आवर चॉइस. हम इनमें से कोई भी सेल यूज कर लेते हैं. इज दैट ओके?
L1 और L2 कौन सी लेंथ है?
हाँ जी बोलो. क्या
L1 एंड L2 कौन सी लेंथ है?
क्या L1 L2 वैल्यूज कौन सी हैं?
की लेंथ है.
मैंने बच्चे आपको बताया कि जब हम पहले की ओपन ही रखेंगे एक रीडिंग तब ले लेंगे. वो जो बैलेंसिंग लेंथ है वो L1 है. फिर हम एक रीडिंग लेंगे लेंथ की, इसको की को क्लोज करते वो L2 है. ठीक है?